Guys, let us start with a new topic, the equilibrium under perfect competition. You know what is perfect competition, right? We have discussed about various market forms, perfect competition or monopoly, monopolistic, everything, right? I've already discussed about those market forms. Now we need to see that what is the equilibrium position or what is the equilibrium condition under perfect competition market. Certain things we need to recall actually, that is under perfect competition, you know, we had, what was the characteristics of perfect competitive market? It has what? Large number of buyers and sellers, right? Let me write it, large number of buyers and sellers. So if there is large number of buyers and sellers, definitely it means that there is no selling cost involved, no selling cost, or you can say this is no trading cost, trading cost. So which means what? Products are homogeneous, products are homogeneous means perfect substitutes are available, perfect substitutes are available, then no transportation cost. That means what? There is free exit, entry and exit of firms, free entry and exit of firms, perfect knowledge about the products, and the another one was no advertisement cost. So these are certain characteristics of the perfect competitive market, and definitely the sellers are not the price makers, they are the price takers. So I can write the sellers are price what? Takers. Now this was about what was the characteristics of the perfect competitive market. Now we have discussed that perfect competitive market has got two parts, that is one, it includes the firms, and the other is the industry. We need to actually make the difference between perfect competitive market, perfect competition under the firms and then the industry. What is actually industry? Industry is the collection of the firms, right? If I discuss about the demand curve, about the demand curve of under perfect competition for the firms. For the firms, the demand curve is perfectly elastic, isn't it? For the firms, this is what? This is x-axis, this is the y-axis. Okay, so for the firms, this is under the firm, under the firm, the perfect competitive market ka demand curve is perfectly elastic. So E at D is equals to what? Infinity. Okay, it is perfectly elastic. Why is it elastic? Because there is a presence of large number of buyers and sellers. So the one particular seller actually doesn't affect much, the particular seller or the buyer doesn't affect the market. Every buyer or seller is actually having a very negligible part in the market. So it does not actually affect the market at all if one buyer says that he is not going to sell the product at that price, or any buyer is refusing to purchase a product. One buyer or one seller does not actually affect the market. So for a particular firm, the demand curve is perfectly elastic. But what happens if it go to industry? If it go to industry, the demand curve is actually negatively sloped. Demand curves are always negatively sloped, isn't it? So here we get a normal demand curve. This means this is for industry. So this means that we have got some difference under firms and under industries. Why is it that difference? Because industry comprises of lots of firms. One firm, whatever the decisions of one firm, it is not affecting the market at all. But when this firm 10-20 firms together giving certain conclusions, then that is actually affecting the market. So that is why industry we have got a normal demand curve, but for a firm we have what? Perfectly elastic demand curve. Now moving on to the thing, while dealing with perfect competitive model, it is essential to keep separate concepts for a firm and an industry. Definitely a firm is not an industry, okay? We have different concepts. A firm, as we know, is an individual enterprise. It is an individual enterprise. An industry, on the other hand, is a group of competing firms selling a well-defined product. Under perfect competition, no single firm or single consumer can influence the price because of its negligible share in the total supply or total demand in the industry. However, price is determined by the collective actions of the firm or the industry through the supply curve of the industry and the collective actions of the consumer. Thus, short run curve equilibrium price and quantity is determined by the interaction of the market demand and the market supply curve. Okay, so when a particular individual firm actually doesn't affect the market, but an industry which comprises of lots of firm affects the market. And in industry, how is the equilibrium position means how do we get the equilibrium position? By the interaction of the demand and supply curve. In the thing which normally happens, so this is the P0 we get and this is the Q0 we get. So this is the equilibrium position for the perfect competitive market in for an industry. Okay, so a firm under perfect competition cannot influence the market price. It is a price taker. A firm under perfect competition does not influence the market price. Definitely we have discussed it already in the features that it is a price taker. The individual firm under perfect competition is assumed to be facing a perfectly elastic demand curve for its product because any variation in its output cover the range feasible for it, while have such negligible effect on the total supply and the market price that effects can be safely assumed to be zero. So actually it is not having any share in the market at all for a particular firm or any particular buyer or seller, whatever we are discussing. The price is given to all the firms as determined in the industry by the forces of market demand and the market supply. Price OP. Now let me draw this. Okay, if I draw this, see, I will be drawing the market demand and supply. This is the market demand and supply. This is the demand P, this is the Q, zero. So this is the equilibrium position which I get, and from here if I continue this, we get, this is another point where P equals to AR equals to MR. We have already drawn the diagrams. You see, the MR was a horizontal line, AR was also horizontal line, which was equals to P. So this is what we have, the P0 and this is the Q0. You see, when the price, if the price is over here, what do we get? We get an excess supply, right, of the commodity. So and if it is here, what do we get? What do I get? This is the excess supply, and this is the here it is, we get the excess demand, and here is the excess supply which we are getting, right? This is the excess supply we are getting. So when we have the excess supply, what will happen? The price will tend to fall, and when we have excess demand, the price will tend to increase, right? So this is what is going to happen. Now a price taker firm will always sell at the MP, and the price taker firm will always sell at the market price. MP is the market price. It follows that the marginal revenue of the firm will be equal to the average revenue, and consider with the market price to form a straight line at any level of output. Okay, at any level of output we get this straight line where P equals to AR equals to MR. Okay, we get this point where whatever may be the output, any level of output, we get this is the position. Why this is the position? Because this is the price at which the firms are willing to produce. Next, you see, so this we discussed about what should be the equilibrium position. So For the firm, we had something, a different equilibrium position, and for industry as a all together, we have some different equilibrium position. For the firms, we had the perfectly elastic market. This is the perfectly elastic market. So in case of a firm, we here the P is actually equals to AR equals to MR. This can be denoted for the firm, right? This is for the firms. This is the P0. So at any level of output, whatever may be the output, you get the equilibrium position, because that is what is the supply, that is what is the demand for in the market. Why? Because it is for a particular firm. A particular firm does not play any role in the whole competitive market. It plays a very, very negligible role. But in case of the industry, we have the normal demand and the supply curve, and the interaction of the demand and supply curve actually gives us the equilibrium position. Why the interaction of demand and supply curve? Because when the price was here at P1, we were facing excess supply. Because of the presence of excess supply, the price was trending to fall at P0, and when we are at P1, it is actually facing a excess demand. Okay, excess demand, so it moves to P0 and again tends to rise to P0. Okay, so as a result, what is happening, the equilibrium position is P0, and with respect to that, we get the equilibrium here, that is P equals to AR equals to MR. We must remember that we in the profit maximizing approach also, we know that MC must be equals to MR, marginal cost should be equals to MR, and here also MR is equals to the price. So it shows that we have reached the equilibrium position. So this was the first part for perfect competitive market equilibrium. Okay, thank you.